twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, you're like a diamond in the sky. As usual, it started when Haney was born, when his first breath was taken and a life was formed. But Haney was so big that his mother was torn. Would a baby ever be accepted part of the norm? Haney's size was only one part of the puzzle. With the cord round his neck, life started a struggle. Form around his little blue lips were bubbles, keeping it from reaching Haney's brain befuddled. Spent the next month in the ICU, in and out of danger playing ICU with his life. But finally Haney's icy hue stabilized and he was sent out nice and new to the home of Misty and her boyfriend Bob, who'd always been abusive and a drunken slob. Could never hold his temper, much less a job. If Haney knew it, would his heart have just stopped? Up above the world so high, you're like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, oh how I wonder what you are. As Haney grew up, it was easy to see that his body had grown bigger than his mind would be. As he approached, as imposing as a redwood tree, but the roots when he opened up his mouth weren't deep. Besides, Bob was working on his self-esteem. Anytime you talked to Haney, eyes would never meet. In fact, all Haney ever saw was feet, cause when he opened up his mouth, he could hardly speak. At school, poor Haney, he was always teased by a group of boys taking Haney out at the knees. Brought him down to size, and the bullies always seized the opportunity to rip him up piece by piece. And Haney never made a fuss, never peeped. Kept his tears inside as his eyelids squeezed. Inside, though his heart was filled with pleas. I don't wanna hurt anymore, I want release. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, oh how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, you're like a diamond in the sky. Misty was impatient with her son, his lack of communication kept a disdain intact. Bob was much more vocal with much less tact, the insults never held back, always on attack. And though he was big, Haney's always scared. No retaliation, no he never dared to stand up for himself, and he was ensnared, locked in his room, out the window he stared. And in Haney's head, he uttered these words of prayer. Oh God, there is a God. Please take me away from this place. I can't do it. I don't want to be here. Please take me away. Please help me. Then appeared in the sky a bright new star. It seemed to be greeting him so bizarre. Haney watched as it came closer from afar and crashed through the wall like a speeding car. Fire all around, smoke filled the air. Haney couldn't see, couldn't hear the blare of the ambulance that took him to the care of the hospital. He took his first breath there as if in a nightmare his spirit sunk. When his dad walked in with a lack of love, doctor said we can keep him but he won't wake up. Last words were his dad's,
no, pull the plug.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, now I know just what you are. Could not see with naked eye the day that Haney's light would die.